expendable batons and sticks are different, but they can still function the same. But one is a little more awkward and a slightly heavier than a rattan stick. With a regular stick, way lighter, way easy to flow, boom, 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 way easier. Try the same thing with a heavier baton. Then see, a little harder because it's a little heavier on your wrist, so some people want to hold it up here to do it faster. But the thing is this has crushing power. This has less crushing power, but it still is going to hurt pretty bad. And you can jab knowing that this isn't going to go back into the handle. Whereas if you don't extend this really, really hard, or you thought you did, and it sometimes goes back in, but I did it pretty good this time. You can conceal it. In Oregon, we have really stupid laws. You can get a concealed carry permit for a handgun and hide it under your clothes, but you can't hide a knife and you can't hide an impact weapon or brass knuckles or anything. So it's a very illogical law. So if you get a baton, you're not allowed to conceal it like that. That's illegal now. You have to keep it open, which is really weird. It's stupid. So if you're gonna use this for self-defense and you wanna be inconspicuous walking down the street, you're gonna wanna cover it up. So you have to make that decision if you wanna break the law that way or not. But your life's at stake, so whatever. Now, what you can do is openly carry it down the street like this. This is legal. You can carry it like that, or you can openly carry it on your person like this, like on your belt. Now, the problem with this is if you got attacked, pulling this out, look how hard, it's not even coming out. Like, it doesn't come out. You have to literally grab, pull out that hard to get it to come out. That's a bad design. There's got to be a better way to carry a baton that comes out fast and stays secure without falling off your belt, you know, coming out from the scabbard without you pulling it. So when you want to, if there's someone attacking you and you're in a fight, bam, and he pulls out a knife, you got to go, that's how long it takes to pull out. It doesn't make any sense. So also, it catches your shirt a lot when you put it in like this. Like, you can get your shirt caught like that, which is really annoying. So you gotta make sure you pull it out of the way. So, pull it out. That's how long it took me to pull it out. Try again and then extend it. So, at that point, it took that long before I was gonna fight. So, then sometimes it doesn't even close. You really gotta hit it hard. And then you see, with a lot of swinging and impact, this handle moves like that. I think it's a flaw in the design. This is gonna go in. And then you see the handle's all screwed up just by trying to shut it. So that's freaking annoying. Now for Kali, we can use a baton in a similar way as you can a stick. So you can still do the equis, you know, salok salok, you can do planchada, whatever. You can even jab, but there's a problem with the ASP. I believe the ASP has a couple weaknesses, like when you fully extend it, sometimes it doesn't stay strong. Like, you can just make it go back in by just tapping it with your hand. Even when you flicked it hard, it doesn't always lock perfectly in place. But when you do get it locked perfectly in place, it's pretty nice. You can still jab. As you can see right now, it's not gonna go in very easy unless I hit it on the ground. You have to hit it on something hard enough to make it go back in, retreat.
So you have to hit it like that.
Then over time with practice, it does chip away and dent. But this is pretty nice. It's not gonna come out. So with an ASP baton, they have a rubber handle. Now there is a problem with the handle that when you start twirling it really fast, it tends to go down. See how it can roll, it can peel off like that. And the handle also is not smooth on the hand, so you could get more of a burn on your hand. But if you practice enough with it, your hand will be calloused enough where it doesn't matter. But a good thing is you can still have a puño right here. But with a baton, it is more forward heavy for some reason. It's not easy to, as easy to pull and twirl with, or hit and pull back. So keep that in mind. It's less smooth to twirl. It's the weight isn't perfectly even, but the great thing about a baton is it's way harder than a stick. It's really gonna hurt. It's a lot harder than you think. This is gonna make someone move. I believe that a baton is more for intimidation, pushing someone away in a situation where you have to detain someone, or basically what the police do. For self-defense, it'll still work, but it's pretty heavy, and it's definitely deadly, more deadly on impact than a stick. If you get an ASP baton, you can get a scabbard for it, which connects to your belt. So you can connect it wherever. I would recommend putting it on the opposite side of your dominant hand. So I'm right-handed. I'll put it on this side. If you did want to use this as a dulo-dulo, which is a palm stick, you can jab like a kubaton, but then it will come out like that, and then it's kind of annoying. Sometimes it comes out like that, which isn't that effective. It's not locked in. See? So if you flick this out and it's not hard enough, it comes right back in by popping it with your hand. It's not that great. So you have to really hit it hard to make it stay out, okay? But you can still put your thumb here and hit, or just, you know, if someone like jab them like that or like that, it still will work like a kubaton. An ASP baton is going to run you about $190. To have this set up with the baton and the scabbard, $190. Do you really need to spend that much for self-defense tools? Well, you be the judge. But an official ASP baton is going to cost that much. And with the tiny bit of flaws in the design, I still think that it's good enough. It's a pretty good weapon for hitting and hurting someone pretty bad. So you have to understand that the force you use with this, that could come back against you in the court of law. So you need to only use this in an encounter where your life is definitely in danger and they're going to kill you if you don't defend yourself. Such as someone pulls a knife, a gun, or they pull out a baton or a baseball bat or something like that. Now, I'm sure a rattan stick can be considered a deadly weapon too, but I think you'll have more leeway with using this and hitting someone than if you use something that's considered a deadly weapon that cops use and things like that. So I think the ASP weapon is good for fighting and self-defense, but there's probably easier things to carry and easier things to use that are an impact weapon or something, and cheaper options, but it's still a pretty solid device. I just have mixed feelings about it. And I find the handle and the grip to be really annoying that it peels down like that. So the more you train with it, the more the handle is gonna peel down over time. There's different handles. There's a foam handle, and then there's rubber, two kinds of rubber handles, and I got this one. So that's basically my review. A baton is used for security, a lot of security guards use it, and police officers. So if you want to get one, you got to kind of be rich. So there you go. You can definitely use this in Filipino martial arts. But I personally, if I was going to face off with someone, I'd rather have the stick. But this is definitely good for intimidation. Once you pull it out, someone's going to get a little scared. They're going to hear the noise. And that's what the ASP Baton website says, that even the noise of it flicking it out is intimidating to people, and that could stop an attack. And when you pull it out, you better make sure you use it properly. And if you hit them in the head, it's going to hurt pretty bad. And they recommend only hitting in the arm or the leg. And that's pretty much what police officers do. Just hit them in the arms or the leg to get them to comply and to kind of direct people, like hooking their arm with it or something, locking them. But most cops really aren't that skilled in martial arts at all. So it's kind of a weapon that people who don't really know how to fight will pull out and try to hit you with it because they don't really have any other way to defend themselves. But it's still cool for what it is, and in a serious fight, if you needed to use it, it's definitely going to do the job. It's definitely going to put someone out big time. So that's my review. I have mixed feelings, whatever. ASP.